What's up, guys? I'm Laura from Reading in Bed, and this is going to be the Booktube Watching Tag, which was originally created by Harriet Rosie, and everyone and their mother has done it at this point, so I'm going to do it too. I don't think I was tagged, and actually that is one of the most annoying things to me about Booktube or just YouTube in general, is that you can't tell when people mention you. On WordPress, you get a notification. But anyways, I'm kind of getting ahead of myself here. 11 questions, so question number one is how many channels are you subscribed to? So it looks like I'm subscribed to about 225, of which I'm sure about 80 to 90% are BookTube. The rest are skincare, makeup, science stuff, and then my kids randomly subscribe me to things because when they use their tablet, they're connected to my account, so like video game channels. Number two is when do you normally watch BookTube? So I was surprised, actually. My habitual way of watching seems to be the way a lot of people watch, which is while getting ready in the morning. That is sort of my key BookTube watching time. So I may get like, 20 to 30 minutes in, and it's typically while I'm putting makeup on. So unfortunately, I'm not usually actually watching, I'm more listening. So sorry to those of you who put a lot of effort into, you know, graphics and transitions and whatnot. I'm probably not seeing it. Question number three, how do you balance BookTube watching, reading, and making your own videos? So these answers did surprise me. I mean, most people said they find it, they're pretty balanced, and they kind of prioritize them in the order of reading first, and then either watching and making or making and watching, depending kind of how serious and how prolific a BookTuber they are. But what I didn't hear people talking about was the fact that good conditions for watching BookTube are also generally good conditions for reading, meaning, you know, when you have a quiet moment and you're not going to be interrupted too much, maybe when you're tired and so you're not in the mood to like actually make something or put a lot of effort into something. Both reading and watching BookTube are sort of equally possible under those conditions. So I find personally, sometimes I have a hard time balancing reading and watching. Like at times when I sort of think I should be reading, I'm like, oh, I just want to kick back and watch some BookTube. Because like in terms of effort, they're both sort of lower on the effort scale, but watching BookTube is a lot less effort than reading, right? You can pretty much turn your brain off depending what kind of video you're watching. I mean, particularly tags and stuff like that. Like that is a total just turn the brain off and zone out. So I find with myself, I have to have a bit of discipline to say, okay, you know, yeah, everyone's in bed. This is like me time. Let's spend some of that reading and not just watching tags on BookTube. Okay, so that was number three. Number four is there a difference between videos you like watching and videos you like making? Well, this one for me is not too applicable because like my technical skills are non-existent, so the types of videos I make are quite limited. I guess in terms of the content I make, sometimes I do tags, pretty rarely do reviews, but I've done some recently, and I do discussions. I guess those are the same kind that I watch, and I don't, you know, the things I don't watch, which tend to be, you know, hauls, wrap-ups, etc., I don't make those. So yeah, I mean, I guess they kind of line up. Number five is, who's the first BookTuber you subscribe to, and do you still watch them? I don't know. As far as I can tell, and this is annoying too, in YouTube, it doesn't like give you a chronological list of how you subscribe to things. However, I did write a blog post in July of 2014, and right in the introduction I say that 3 months ago I didn't know what BookTube was, and then I was sort of explaining it to my my blogging audience, because in 2014 a lot of people didn't know. And so I listed a bunch, well, like five channels, so those would have been among the first, but I don't know which was first. And I'm sure that, well, I know that I found BookTube the way a lot of you do, through crazy YA channels. Do I still watch them? No. except for once in a while, I will kind of go back and just like check in with some of those big top 10 channels, and then I slowly back away. Number six is, who is the most recent booktuber you subscribe to? So I was able to check that just through looking at my recent history, and that was Acacia Ives, who's a booktuber I've been aware of for a long time. And I sort of found her again because I was looking at reviews of Freshwater by, I'm not going to get her name right without having it in front of me. I think it's Amizi. So I was looking for reviews, and her review was really good. The book kind of touches on dissociative identity disorder, and Acacia talks, you know, really eloquently about that. So then I just hit that subscribe button. Let's see, number seven, share an old favorite booktuber. I'm going to go with Bez Pierce, who has recently returned to the fold with a Patreon and everything. I'm shocked that through all these tags I've watched, because I've watched a lot of them, no one's mentioned him. I mean, you know, get with it, guys. Bez Pierce. I'll link him down below. Number eight is Sheriff, new favorite booktuber. That has got to be Challenge Thyself. I'll link her down below as well. I mean, she's a favorite, like, just overall, let alone new booktubers. She is wonderful. I love the way she talks about books. I love, you know, kind of her snarky tone, but, like, with tons of intelligence and lots of analysis. And she is so good at tags. Like, I watch a lot of these things, and they do tend to get repetitive, but she always has sort of a unique spin on the same old tags. So check her out. Number nine is the question everyone comes here for. What is one of your BookTube pet peeves? Well, I've talked about BookTube pet peeves quite a lot in my past videos, so I'm not going to rehash, you know, uptalk and all those things that I hate, and flailing and what, I mean, you know, whatever. But I do have a more specific one, and it's actually a sin I just committed, which is ironic, but it's when people don't research how to pronounce author names. Now, in my defense, I didn't know, like, I didn't rehearse this, and I didn't know I was gonna talk about Freshwater until I did. But I'm talking about more like when it's a review, okay? So you're reviewing a book, the author has a name that you don't know how to pronounce, you sit down to do your review, and you spend, especially when you spend a lot of time either apologizing or sort of like non-apologizing, like saying, okay, I'm probably gonna like butcher this name. I don't know. It's, I think it's like, and then, you know, like giving a really bad attempt at pronouncing the name and just like kind of giggling through it. And it's like, if you knew you were doing this review, take 30 seconds, Google them on YouTube, and find a video where either they're saying their own name or someone is introducing them at an event or something. It is not that fucking hard. And it's like so embarrassing to watch. And the one that I saw recently was like not just an individual booktuber, it was someone booktubing on behalf of a company. In other words, they were probably getting paid to make that video, and I was just so, I was cringing. Anyways. Okay, number 10 is, what have you learned from watching other booktubers? I don't think I have a succinct answer for that. I mean, like, you could talk about that from the technical perspective, which is, I guess, for me, probably not much, just because I haven't put a lot of effort into learning technical skills. Learned lots about books and literary analysis and different perspectives and, like, the literature of other countries. You know, one off the top of my head is, The Bookish Land. The Bookish Land, her channel, she talks a lot about Chinese literature and almost in a very educational way. She has a video series about it. So I learned about Chinese literature from her, went on to read some Eileen Chang, who is now one of my favorite authors. So, like, very specific things. I don't think there's, like, an overall thing I've learned. I learned lots of little things here and there, and it all sort of just adds to my body of knowledge, which is great. And 11 is just tag some of your favorite booktubers. So like I said, everyone's done this, but I'll tag Bez Pierce if he wants to do it. I'll tag Jason Purcell, who's another old favorite. And I'll just tag anyone else who hasn't done this yet. Now, I am planning to do a short sort of addendum to this tag, as I had some other things I wanted to discuss about watching BookTube. So watch for that soon, but thanks for watching this tag.